Hey beauties, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I will be sharing some of my favorite products from the month of May. It also means that today marks the end of Everyday May, to which I say, good riddance. In case you're not aware, at the very beginning of this month, I challenged myself to upload a new video every single day. I failed miserably. I think I ended up skipping 5 or 6 days, which is quite a lot. I thought I would do better than I did, but it was very ambitious. And man, I never could quite get caught up. I feel like I've just been dragged along the entire month. I saw a meme the other day. It said, this month has been the longest year ever. That's exactly how I feel about the month of May. Now I kind of have an idea of how much work it takes to accomplish that. So I feel like I will still be a better YouTuber and a more regular, consistent uploader because of that challenge. But let's get into all of these makeup products because I have a lot of great stuff sitting in front of me. And I'm going to begin with hair. Here's a product that I don't think I've talked about in a really long time, but it's almost gone. I use this all the time. And every time I use it, I think to myself, oh, I'm so grateful for this product. I love it. I'm obsessed with it. I can't believe I don't really talk about it more. I guess it's sort of rare that I talk about hair products, but this would be on my must-have list. Like, I cannot go without this product. I use it every single time I style my hair. This is the Amika The Shield Anti-Humidity Spray. I very rarely use hairspray. Couple times a year, honestly. I just never use hairspray. I feel like it wrecks my hair, so I don't like to use it regularly. This never makes my hair feel dry. I've resisted the urge to look at the ingredients, but I can tell you my hair does not feel dry at all. It does not have that same feeling of hairspray, and it doesn't make my hair feel crispy or crunchy, and it doesn't have, you know, the flakes whenever I run my fingers through my hair the way hairspray gives you, like, that dandruff afterwards. Nothing like that. So it just really protects against humidity, and what I do is I'll do my curls using the T3 wand, and I just go crazy with this. I just spray. It's a continuous mist. It does smell really nice, but I just spray, 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 and I spray a long time. I'm generous. I don't skimp. It's not like I do a light little layer and that's why my hair doesn't feel dry. No, I coat my hair with this stuff. And then I do my best to not touch the curls for a couple hours. Sometimes I can't help it, but the curls will last days. Like, I styled my hair yesterday and I brushed through them a little bit. I want you to be able to see there's a lot of curl. That's not bad for second day hair, running my fingers through it. I slept on my hair and it still has a lot of bounce, and my hair is very long, but it will stay curly for days. I mean, I'll be able to wear this style without any dry shampoo or anything else, no other styling products, for probably 2 more days. By day 4, it starts to look completely flat, and then I generally wash it. Let me fix it now that I messed up my hair. But that anti-humidity spray, this is the only thing I spray in my hair after I've styled it to hold the curl. This next hair care product has been a lifesaver. This is the Kérastase Discipline Oleo Relax Mask. I picked this up during the Sephora sale. It is amazing. I've used it 3 times now. Definitely my favorite hair mask of all of the masks I picked up recently, but I think it's just my favorite mask all around. It's so good. It truly does make your hair feel so much softer. Like, it's not even my hair. I don't know. I don't recognize the hair on my head. It feels so soft. This is exactly what I was looking for. So I'm really happy that one of the masks really worked out. The only one that I'm sort of on the fence with, a little bit disappointed with, is that Verb Purple Mask. It's great that it tones, but it's not very hydrating. I used that the last time because I wanted to give it another shot. It's okay, but it's also like $18, so not terrible. This truly is a mask. It is going to help repair your hair. It's really, really nourishing. Next, I want to shout out one of my new favorite cleansers. I talked about this in my morning skincare routine video. This is the Sulwhasoo Gentle Cleansing Oil. I love a cleansing oil. I never thought that would be something that I needed in my life, but I never pass up an opportunity to try a new one. So this was sent to me complimentary. I requested to review this, and I'm obsessed with it. I actually prefer this to the Chanel oil cleanser, which I love. This just feels a little bit thicker, and you can see it's not thick, but it just feels a little bit, I don't know, it's more dense, it's silky. It feels so nice, and I use this to remove my makeup in the evenings. So I keep this outside of the shower right by the sink, and I'll usually pump 2 pumps in my hand, and then before it all slides through my fingers and goes right down the drain, I splash it on my face, and I just kind of work it around, just kind of massage the face. It's gentle enough. I use this on my eyes. I've never had a problem. Of course, if you wear contacts or you have really sensitive eyes, I wouldn't do that, but I use this for everything. I just massage it all around, and then I get in the shower, rinse it off, and then I go in with a foaming cleanser, and it works perfectly. It truly does remove most all of my makeup in a really gentle way. It doesn't strip the skin. I generally feel like I have to go in with that second cleanser. That's just me, and I generally have a lot of makeup on my face, but it's a great makeup remover. Really, really love this. I picked up a couple new primers this month, including the Super Goop Glow Screen with SPF 40 and the Varsali Liquid Glass. Now, of the two, I think my favorite is the Glow Screen, and this is maybe 46 or 48, and this is 34, I believe. Really reasonable price. It looks beautiful. This might be my new favorite radiance primer. I'm wearing the By Terry today. That is up there. That's always one of my favorites. But I love this. I love the fact that it has SPF 40 and it truly does grab your makeup. You know, it's a great makeup primer. If you want to get the full SPF 40, you're going to have to use a lot. But on days that you're just running out the door, you want your skin to look luminous and radiant and heaven sent, the Glow Screen is incredible. But I think this looks really good underneath a matte foundation because it kind of balances it out. A lot of my favorite long wear foundations happen to be matte, so I love the idea of pairing this with those. That way you get your sun protection, your luminosity, you know, it looks like you have this healthy, radiant skin, but then your foundation isn't going to budge on you. I'm gonna need that this summer. I'm so impressed with it. It just looks so pretty. Now the Varsali, I wasn't sure how I felt about it the first time because I was expecting this level of radiance. It doesn't quite have that, but what it does have is grip. So you put it on and it kind of dries down on the face and it leaves you with a little bit of that tack, which is so perfect for grabbing your foundation, making sure that it doesn't budge throughout the day. And it does give you a little bit of radiance. It also has skincare benefits, which is why it's a make skin serum. It's makeup skincare. All in one. Thank you to the viewer who pointed that out because I was so confused the first time. Here I am passing it off as if I knew that. I didn't. But this liquid glass, I love this. I would be interested to try some of the other Varsali drops now. You know, it's kind of lured me in. I want to see what else do they have. I'm curious now because the liquid glass, I love it. I have a few more face products here to talk about. This has got to be the biggest surprise of the month. Might even end up being the biggest surprise of the year. This is the Jane Iredale Circle Delete Concealer. I have shade 1. I cannot believe how creamy and natural and crease resistant and beautiful this concealer is. This was sent to me complimentary. The first time I tried it, it looked so beautiful and I just thought it was a fluke. I thought there's no way that this creamy concealer is looking so nice and not creasing on me. I kept using it. No problems ever arose. It's just a great concealer and I feel like nobody really talks about it, but it deserves a lot more recognition than it gets. Now, it doesn't give a ton of coverage, so if you're looking to conceal a blemish, if you're looking to conceal dark circles under the eye, I don't think this is going to be best for you. I could recommend 5 or 6 other concealers. But it does have this darker shade, which would be nice for spots on the face, you know, as long as it's nothing that's too noticeable. You know, you could do a little concealing. And then they have this really light shade. And the reason why it doesn't look so light anymore is I kind of mix the two together. And I just apply and blend it out with my finger. I don't even use a brush. And it has got to be the most natural looking concealer I own. I think I prefer this to the Armani Luminous Silk Concealer as well. It's just so creamy. You know, it maintains a hydrated, luminous look. Beautiful. And then I picked up a couple new blushes this month from Chanel. Of the five new shades that I added to my collection, my two new favorites, Evening Beige and Quintessence. And I probably could have guessed that from the get-go because these were the two shades that were must-haves. You know, I added them to cart right away and I knew I needed these to talk about them. Evening Beige is just the perfect soft neutral blush. It's going to pair beautifully with a poppy lip, with golden bronze skin. It's a great summer shade. Has a little bit of gold shimmer, barely detectable on the cheeks. It's just very pretty. Leans a little bit more peachy, whereas Quintessence is kind of that true rosy pink. This is the quintessential blush. It is that perfect pink flush. I just love this shade so much, and it's kind of a warmish pink. Quintessence is more matte. It is the perfect shade for spring summer looks. It's a very happy blush. The brush is trying to escape. I'm gonna do my best not to lose that and to hold on to it. I'm not sure that won't last very long. Those are my two favorites. Moving on to eyes, I have a couple products here to talk about. These eyeliners I picked up, I want to say in January, so it's nothing new, but I've been using them so much lately, and I started off using just the black this month. I don't know what got into me. I started experimenting with the other shades I picked up, finally. So this is the Bronze Doré 522. I used this a lot, and I love it. I wish this wasn't limited. It is still available, but at some point, they're supposed to go away with this shade. They do have a dark brown, but I like this copper brown. I think it is so pretty because it truly does look different than the black. You know, the reddish brown that I'm wearing today and the deep, deep brown, yeah, they're going to look a little bit softer maybe, but you're not really going to be able to notice unless you're standing really close to somebody. From a distance, it's just gonna look like black eyeliner. Whereas this one, I feel like it really stands out and you can tell that it's not black. I really like that one. I really like this blue, the 526. Perhaps it's a bit early to call this a favorite. I think I only used it once this month, but I really loved my look overall. And I think this blue eyeliner is what made the look. So I cannot recommend this enough. It's not a deep, deep navy. You can tell that it is blue. It's closer to a royal blue than a deep navy blue, which is why I think this is so pretty. This one is not limited, I believe. I think this one is going to be around forever, and I'm so thankful. The makeup look I created was using this brand new Dior palette. This is 287 Dive, part of their summer collection. I love this. It is my favorite blue eyeshadow palette. Blue eyeshadow is tough. Can be difficult to feel comfortable in. I know sometimes I feel really uncomfortable wearing blue eyeshadow. You know, it's fine if I'm just playing around and experimenting here at home, but I wouldn't necessarily feel really good and feel really confident to leave the house. Well, the look I created with this palette, I loved. I will be recreating that time and time again. I feel like I now have that go-to blue look. So that the next time I want to experiment with color, if I'm wearing like an all white outfit and I want to do something really fun with my makeup, I can just pull this palette out, whip up that exact same look, and I will feel amazing about it. I won't feel uncomfortable. That's tricky. So I think Dior did a really beautiful job. I love how cohesive this palette is. Ugh, definitely my favorite blue palette. One of my favorite Dior palettes. I think this is really stunning. I also picked up the Sprint palette. This is beautiful. This is the other side of the spectrum. The blue palette is all jewel tones, and then these are the warmer shades. I love this little pink. It's very different from the other pinks that we've seen. It's that bubblegum Pepto-Bismol pink. It's a really pretty pop of color. And I love the orange. This is so pretty. It is so summery. This is kind of the ideal palette, I would say, for summer. I need to play around with it more. I know I've said that I don't really love these brown colors in the crease. I didn't have a great first impression. I worked with it. Now I love it. I'm gonna keep working at it. Right now, I think this might be my favorite summer collection, at least in terms of eyeshadow. Really nice. Last but not least, I just have to call out this Ombre Premier Lac. This is Rising Sun number 24 from Chanel. I got a lot of use out of this again in May. And prior to that, I hadn't really touched this. We're bombarded with new launches all the time. I'm constantly trying new stuff. I hate that something that's 2 or 3 months old feels forgotten about too soon. So I love this. I took it back out. I was playing around with it. I think these are great. This color in particular is the one that I grab most often. I also picked up the purple. I feel like that's better for smoky eyes. I haven't needed to do a smoky eye anytime recently. But this Rising Sun is absolutely gorgeous. I love the sheen. It's kind of warm, coppery, rose gold. You know, it's just that perfect summer shade. And they work really well with powder shadows. So you can lay this down first as a base and put something on top of it. Or you could just use this with your fingers, blend it out, a little something on the lid and go. They're very easy. I feel like I'm guilty of always talking about the same lipsticks or wearing the same lipsticks, but for today's video, I'm wearing the Marc Jacobs 242 No Angel, and I top that off with the Pillow Talk Collagen Lip Bath from Charlotte Tilbury. In case anybody's interested, this would be one of my favorites for the month. I just think this nude is so pretty, so different from anything else that I have. It's a brown nude, so that has to appeal to you or else you're gonna hate this. I didn't necessarily love it the first time I threw it on, but my trick is to top it off with a gloss and then I think it's really pretty. It's the perfect nude that isn't a pinky nude. That completes my list of May favorites. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Leave me your comments, questions down below. I love hearing your recommendations. You guys have great taste in makeup, so if you have any favorite products from the past month, definitely drop me a comment. We will keep the conversation going there. As always, I will be linking everything mentioned, everything on my face, down in the description box for your convenience. And for more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell.